हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्टडी ऑफ मल्टी वाइब्रेटर्स यूजिंग IC555 एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 36236। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ इट वर्क्स। सो दिस इज अ मल्टी वाइब्रेटर ट्रेनर किट यूजिंग IC555। सो हियर वी आर हैविंग अ स्क्वायर वेव सिग्नल जनरेटर ऑफ 1 kHz। सो दिस इज द पोर्ट for square wave signal generator. Then this is the power supply section. Here we are having 10 volt DC power supply and this is the ground port. Then this is the main power on off switch. These are the capacitors. This is the IC555 section. Here we are having all the pins of the IC555. Then these are the resistance. Then these are also the resistance and these are two diodes. Then this is the LED. This is the PNP transistor, then this is the variable potentiometer of 47K. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study bistable multivibrator using IC555 and output through LED. So for that we have to do the connections first. The connection diagram is given in the manual. Here you can see that. So this is the connection we have to do on the kit. Now firstly we will connect the second port of IC to the 10K resistance like this, and now we will connect the other end of 10K resistance to the fourth pin of IC like this, and now we will connect the fourth pin of IC to the eighth pin of IC like this, and now we will connect the 8th pin of the IC, that is the VCC, to the power supply section. So here we will connect it with the positive. Now we will connect the 6th port of the IC to the 10K and the other port of the 10K is connected to the ground. Now we will connect a probe at 10K and we will leave it like this, and now we will connect another probe at 10K where we have connected the second pin of IC. We will keep this also like this, and now we will connect the 8th port of IC to 1K resistance, and the other end of 1K resistance is connected to the third port of IC, and now we will connect the 1K resistance port to 1μF capacitor and the other port is connected to ground. Now we will connect the third pin of IC to the LED and the other end is connected to the ground. Now we will connect the first pin of IC to the ground and we will connect the fifth pin of IC to capacitor 0.01. And we will connect the other end of the capacitor to ground. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit, and here we can see that the LED is at off position right now. Now we will take the two wires which we left while doing the connections at 10K. So firstly we will take the wire which is connected to the 10K and which is directly connected to the IC pin number 2. So we have to take this probe 2 and we have to connect it to give it a set value. So in the manual it is written that we have to connect this momentarily at ground. So we will connect it at ground. So here you can see that I have connected it at ground, and we can see that the LED is on, which means that it keeps the output Q at one level. Because the LED is on, so it is indicating that it is at on level. Now we will connect the other probe, that is the probe which is connected to the sixth pin of the IC. So we will connect it with power supply 10 to keep this output position at 0. So when we connect it, we can see that the output is 0. But first we have to remove this set 1. So here you can see that. So when you again remove both of the probes, and you will provide the set value, that is the output is 1. So here you can see that the LED glows, and when you remove it, it's still at 1 position. So if you want to keep the output at 0, we have to connect the probe which is connected to the 6th pin of IC. So we will connect it to the positive of power supply. So here you can see that the output is 0, and when you remove it, it still in 0 state, which is written in the manual. The procedure is written in the manual. So that is how you can perform this experiment. So in this experiment, when we connect the second pin of the IC, which is connected to the 10K, when we connect this with the ground momentarily, this will set the output Q to one level, that is high level. This state will be permanently stable. This is called set operation. So when you remove the probe, the output will still be 1. So when you connect the 6th pin of IC to the VCC, that is the power supply, plus 10 volt, then the output Q will be set to 0 level or low level. This is called reset or clear operation. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study a stable multivibrator using IC555 and output through LED. So the circuit is given in the manual. Here you can see that. So we have to do the connections according to this circuit. So firstly, we will connect the second pin of IC to the sixth pin, and we will connect the sixth pin to 0.1 mu F capacitor, and we will connect the other end to the ground like this. And now we will connect the 0.1 mu F capacitor to 10K, and we will connect the other end of 10K to 7th pin of IC. And now we will connect the 4th pin of IC to 10K, and we will connect the other end of 10K to the 7th pin. Now we will connect the 4th pin of the IC to the 8th pin, and we will connect it with the positive 10 volt of power supply. And now we will connect the 8th pin to 1K, and the other end is connected to 3 pin of IC. And now we will connect the 3rd pin of IC to the LED, and the other end of the LED is connected to the ground. And now we will connect the 1st pin of IC to ground, and we will connect the 5th pin of IC to 0.01 mu F, and the other end of the capacitor will be connected to ground. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the DSO Here we will see the waveform. And now we will switch on the kit. So here you can see that the LED is on. Now we will observe the waveform on the DSO. So we will connect the DSO probe between ground and third pin of the IC, that is the output pin of the IC. So here you can see that this is the waveform which we get at the IC pin number third. And now we will check the waveform at capacitor. So we are checking the waveform at capacitor 0.1 μF. So here you can see that this is the waveform which we get at 0.1 μF capacitor. You can cross check the waveforms in the manual. So here you can see that these are the waveforms which we get at output, that is, this is the square wave which we get at IC pin number third, and this is the capacitor waveform which we get at 0.1 μF capacitor. So firstly we will check the square wave at output pin of IC, that is third. So we have connected the ground to the ground, and we will connect this probe to the IC pin number 3, that is the output pin of the IC. So here you can see that this is the square wave, and now we will check the capacitor waveform. So we will connect the ground to the ground, and we will connect this positive to the 0.1 μF capacitor. So here you can see that. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform experiment for a stable multivibrator with duty cycle variable from 0 to 100% and frequency constant. So for that, the connection is given in the manual. Here you can see that this is the circuit diagram which we have to connect in this trainer. So firstly we have to connect this connections on the trainer kit. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit. So we have to do the connections according to this circuit diagram. So I have done the connections here. Now after switching on the kit, we can see that the LED is glowing very low. Now we have to rotate this 47k potentiometer pot to increase the brightness of this LED. So you have to rotate it in clockwise direction. Firstly we have to keep it at fully anti-clockwise direction, and now we will slowly rotate this potentiometer in clockwise direction. So here we can see that the LED brightness increases as we increase the output values. Now when you again rotate this potentiometer in anti-clockwise direction, we can observe that the LED brightness decreases. So as you increase or as you rotate this potentiometer pot in clockwise direction, the brightness of LED increases. So as I am rotating this potentiometer in clockwise direction, the brightness of LED increases. Here you can see that. We can also observe the waveform on the DSO. So for that we will connect the ground to the ground, and we will connect the positive to the output port 3. So at first we have kept this potentiometer pot at fully anti-clockwise direction. So here we can see that there is no output, and now we will slowly increase the output values. So here you can see that we are getting output waveforms. So as you rotate this potentiometer pot, which is 47k pot, so as you rotate this in clockwise direction, the brightness of LED increases and we get the output on the DSO. Now when I again decreases the value, you can see the changes on the square wave. Here you can see that. So that is how you can perform this experiment, and you can observe the output on the DSO and you can also observe the output on the output LED. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.